So we'll go on to the fourth factor, that is the temperature of the reaction, or what we call the reactants. Okay. The rate of a chemical reaction also depends upon the temperature of the reaction. Greater the temperature of the reaction, higher is the rate of the reaction, and vice versa. So it is very obvious. If the temperature is more, the reaction will happen faster. For example, in your house, if you want to cook the food faster, what do? You increase the flame of the gas, no? You increase the temperature. If you increase the flame, the food will get cooked faster. And if you decrease the flame, the food will get cooked slowly. So same thing, similar to this, no? So if you increase the temperature, obviously the rate of the reaction, speed of the reaction will be more. So let's see one example. For example, limestone, no? Not just a limestone, no? Shahabad stone, limestone, calcium carbonate decomposes only on heating to release carbon dioxide gas, which turns lime water milky. Last year you learned, no? When carbon dioxide gas is passed through lime water, it turns milky. Now, lime water is what? What is lime water? It is not limbu paniya. It is not lemon juice, okay? Lime water. Or lime, as you see, sweet lime, Mosambika juice, no? You call it Mosambi sweet lime, no? In chemistry, when I say lime water, it means calcium hydroxide mixed in water. So when you mix calcium hydroxide in water, you get lime water. So when you pass carbon dioxide through lime water, you get lime water, which is colorless like water, turns milky or whitish in color. So everybody is clear? So limestone only decomposes on heating. So if you don't heat the limestone, carbon dioxide gas will never be formed. We learned this in one of the earlier reactions, if you remember. Okay. In endothermic reaction, we learned about this. So generally, the rate of a chemical reaction doubles or triples for every 10 degree rise in the temperature of the reaction. This is said, generally said, that every time you increase the temperature by 10 degree, the reaction rate will either double or triple. Now, when I say it will double or triple, so let's say there is at 20 degree Celsius, the reaction takes 10 minutes to this thing complete. So at 30 degree, when I increase by 10 degree, what will happen? Will it take 20 minutes, double, 10 ka double 20 minutes? No. The rate of the reaction is doubling, means for the time will become half. In other words, the same reaction which was taking 10 minutes to complete will now be completed in just 5 minutes. Why? Because I increased the temperature by 10 degrees. So time taken will be less. That means the speed of the reaction will be more. Let's proceed to the last factor. So we move on to the fifth factor, which affects the speed of a chemical reaction, and that is catalyst, a very important factor. So the presence of a catalyst enhances the speed of a chemical reaction. Enhances means it increases the speed of a chemical reaction. So what is a catalyst? Let's see. A catalyst is a substance whose presence changes the rate of a chemical reaction without causing any chemical change to it. Okay. So what is a catalyst? A catalyst is a substance which you add in the chemical during a chemical reaction. What does a catalyst do? It will speed up the chemical reaction. It will speed up. But without causing chemical change means what? He will not react with the reactants. He will not react with the reactants. Okay, because if he reacts the reactants, the products will change. His job is to only speed up the chemical reaction. He will not take part in the reaction. He will only increase the speed of the reaction. Let's see an example. For example, potassium chlorate decomposes very slowly on heating to give oxygen gas. Yes? So the reaction that I have given the chemical equation there, potassium chlorate on heating. Okay, the heat word is written in the bracket on the right hand, as I told you, no? Because I'm actually supposed to write it on the arrow. because of space thrown away written on the right hand side. So it is a very slow reaction, as you can see. Potassium chloride decomposes slowly. That's why I've underlined the word slowly. So what will you do if you want to? So if you want to rate the rate of this reaction, this particular reaction of potassium chloride decomposing on heating, neither increases by reducing the size of the particle of potassium chloride nor by increasing the what temperature. Even if I increase the temperature or decrease the size, I make powdered potassium chloride, or I increase the temperature of the reaction, it will, the rate of the reaction will still not increase. Okay, so what is the, what we have only one option then. What is that? So what's, let's see that. However, potassium chloride decomposes rapidly. Now rapidly means quickly, in the presence of manganese dioxide to liberate oxygen gas. So if I want potassium chloride to decompose faster, then I have to add manganese dioxide. Now what is manganese dioxide? Here manganese dioxide acts as a catalyst. Okay, also no chemical change occurs in manganese dioxide during the reaction. So manganese dioxide does not react with potassium chloride at all. It remains as it is. He only speeds up the chemical reaction. Let's give you one more example. So I hope this is clear, boys. So if you see in the companies where they make oxygen cylinders, they use potassium chloride. They heat potassium chloride and oxygen gas is released, and that oxygen gas is stored in the cylinders and supplied to the hospitals for those patients who have got breathing problems. For mountaineers who want to climb high mountain, they have to take oxygen cylinders. So this is sold in the market. So this reaction is very slow. So what do? These company people, they add manganese dioxide in the potassium chloride to speed up the chemical reaction so that they can produce more oxygen, and therefore they can manufacture more of oxygen cylinders. Let's see one more example. Similarly, the decomposition of hydrogen peroxide into water and oxygen takes place slowly at room temperature. If you remember, in the decomposition reaction, we learned decomposition reaction in the first method of classification. We saw this reaction, right? So that reaction of hydrogen peroxide breaking down into water and oxygen takes place very slowly at room temperature. At what? Room temperature. However, the same reactions occurs at a faster rate on adding manganese dioxide powder to it, which acts as a catalyst. So if you add manganese dioxide powder, then the oxygen gas will come out very quickly. But if you leave it at room temperature, it will be very slow reaction. So understand what's a catalyst. So we have see that. So now manganese dioxide is not the only catalyst in the whole world. Okay, there are many different types of catalysts for different reactions. Okay, so manganese dioxide is one of the catalysts. Okay, it is not the only catalyst, because both the examples are given manganese dioxide. So don't get confused. Okay, there are many other catalysts in the world, many other substances. So we now see some reactions which happen in our day-to-day life. For example, something very common like corrosion. No, corrosion. So what is corrosion? The slow process of destruction or decay of a metal due to the effect of atmospheric gases, acid, moisture, etc. is called as corrosion. So you see metals. No, we have seen metals. They corrode. Bolo sadte. The best example I can give is iron. You see iron, no? Especially in the rainy season, iron gets rusted. Na? The Marathi matlab na gansate. And jang, Hindi mein bolte hai, jang khata hai. Lohand ko jang lagta hai, na? Apna, aur lohe ko jang lagta hai. So, rusting is a type of corrosion. Okay? Rusting is a type of corrosion. So all metals, they corrode. So whenever you expose a metal to any atmospheric gas, or some acids fall on it, or some moisture, there is moisture, like example I give you just now, iron, no? It gets corroded. They get corroded. So it's a very slow process. Very important, boys. It's a slow process. It doesn't happen overnight. If I take my Lokhandaka cycle, like no, any cycle, if I keep it in the rain season in the night, in the morning, will it rust in the morning? No. It takes so many, if we keep it out your cycle without put, you know, for a long time in the rain, you expose it to rain, slowly, slowly it will start getting rusted. Okay, so corrosion is a very slow process. It's a very slow process. Due to various components of the atmosphere, oxidation of metals take place, consequently resulting in their damage. This is called corrosion. Now all metals, now in the textbook this is given, this statement, I don't agree with this statement much, because not all metals while corroding undergo oxidation. Okay, not all metals undergo, only I can say iron, when it is rusting it undergoes oxidation, but not all metals. So somehow I don't agree with this statement, but since this is given in a textbook, I have written it. So what does corrosion do? It damages buildings, no? In the buildings we use iron and all, iron rods and all. It damages buildings. So as when the building iron rods and all, they get damaged, the buildings fall down, the bridges fall down, no? Damage buildings, bridges, automobiles, like, you know, I mean your cars, bikes and all, no? They have got iron parts, Lokhandaka parts, or whatever, copper parts and all, no? They are made of metals. Ships and other articles which are made of iron. Mainly made of iron. So iron is the most common, you know, the high, one of the metals which is very highly vulnerable or susceptible to or prone to corrosion. No? Iron gets corroded or rusted, whereas gets rusted very fast. How can you prevent corrosion? It can be prevented by using anti-rust solution, like in the, you know, you for your cycle on the handle, wherever the iron parts are there, you always use an anti-rust solution. No? You buy anti-rust solution from the hardware shop and you coat it on the iron handles, no? Or the Lokhandaka parts. Coating the surface with oil or enamel based paints containing zinc or magnesium. Yes. So, for example, if you see, remember these ships and all, no? The whole day they are in the sea and they are made of iron. So, they have a high chance of getting rusted or corroded. So, what happened? They use enamel-based paints to paint the ship to prevent them from corroding. And processes like alloying. We alloy metals. Why do we alloy metals? Why do we make alloys? To prevent them from getting corroded, no? Prevent them getting corroded. Galvanizing. What is galvanizing? What is galvanizing done? Galvanizing done for iron articles, no? When you have iron pipes, if you want to stop them from rusting, I galvanize them. I give them a coating of zinc. So when I coat the iron with zinc, the iron surface with zinc, it will not get corroded. Then tinning. Anodizing. Anodizing is done for aluminium articles like cookers, pressure cookers and all the aluminium cooking pans and all utensils. We anodize them so that they don't get corroded, because aluminium also gets corroded. And electroplating with other metals like silver, gold or chromium plating. So if you see the bumpers of your car, no, the bumpers, the shields of your, you know, the front bumpers, they are always coated with chromium. Because chromium does not get, that stops the bumper, the iron bumper from getting corroded. So when you give a chromium plating, or if you put a silver coating or a gold plating, because gold is a noble metal. So if you coat any substance with gold, then it will not get corroded, because noble metals do not undergo corrosion. Who are the noble metals you learned in your lower classes? One is gold and one is platinum. And also don't forget oil paints. If you have iron grills, no, in your house, if you have iron grills in the balcony, the grills, or no, what do you put? You coat them, you paint them with oil paint. So oil paint also, because oil paint do not allow water to come in contact with the iron surface, because you know iron gets rusted when it comes in contact with the moisture or water.